Here are the latest stories making headlines among the Filipino community. In the San Francisco Bay Area, the tributes continue to pour in for former Philippine President Noynoy Aquino 2 weeks after his death.
Singing Alleluia.
In Northern California, members of the Philam community celebrated their 4th of July in a unique way by holding a memorial mass for the late president on a Half Moon Bay cliff with a shrine for the Blessed Virgin Mary. Officers of the U.S. Filipinos for Good Governance say Pinoy's life and leadership inspire them. They say Pinoy helped change the perception of Philippine politics and actually helped Philams get elected in the U.S.
I want to say that after he was elected, the perception changed so that by 2012, a Filipino in Alameda could get elected to the assembly. That's Rob Bonta. I don't believe it's a coincidence that this happened after Pinoy was elected in 2010. And we started seeing more Filipinos get elected to various positions in California, around the country, because now the perception of Filipinos as being capable of leadership, of integrity, had changed because of Pinoy.
Attorney Ted Laguatan hopes that the lives of Pinoy and his parents, Ninoy and Cory, continue to inspire overseas Filipinos to always do their part to help the homeland.
So, let's keep on praying. Never lose hope. We will never be separated from our homeland, the Philippines. And we will always support a better life for our people back there. Even if we're here, we never forget them. And we always fight against evil. We do not turn our back against evil. We face them bravely, courageously, and have faith, a strong faith, and love for our Lord and our Blessed Mother.
Body shaming, colorism, and cancel culture. These are just some of the sensitive issues facing Filipino millennials. And two sisters in Canada are shedding light on them through a podcast series that's now making waves. Filipino Fridays, the podcast, started a few months after George Floyd's tragic death in May 2020. Archie Rose and Archia Angeli Natividad said the incident impacted them so much that it made them think of who they are and of the importance of upholding their culture and heritage. Their first episode tackled the issue of reconciling the younger generation with their Filipino identity.
We didn't expect anything. It blew up. Like, you know, within the week, there were 1,000 downloads. And it really surprised us because we didn't expect such a reaction. And then it sunk into us. So many people are now looking to reflect and looking to reconnect with their Filipino roots.
Filipino Fridays also discusses the generation gap between millennials and their elders, as well as sensitive topics like colorism, body shaming, cancel culture, Filipino style, family feuds, and other, well, toxic Filipino attitudes. Over in Surfside, Florida, rescuers have given up hope on finding anyone alive in the ruins of a collapsed condo building. The search and rescue operation at the ill-fated Miami area condo complex has turned into a recovery mission. And family members were told there was no longer hope that anyone would be found alive. Six more bodies were recovered on Thursday morning, and the death toll from the building that collapsed last June 24th has hit 60. They include 69-year-old Filipina Maricoy Obayes Bonifoy, whose relatives are struggling to come to terms with their loss. 80 are still unaccounted for. And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories on Balitang America on I Want TFC and the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Back to Mike and Nikki for the rundown.